Comparing different generations of Ryzen in Star Citizen. That is what this video is all about. I've got the 1000, 2000, 3000, 5000 series. Got them all off eBay, spent loads of money. It's taken loads of time to do all the testing. So if you like this sort of content, subscribe. But let's get into the video. So let's just talk about how we're doing this and look at the setup that I'm testing all this on. I've got, very fortunately, a 400 series motherboard, which means I can test all the way from 1000 all the way up to 5000 series chips. So that means all I've done is popped each Ryzen CPU in with my cooler and tested it. The system is exactly the same. We've got a 3080, which basically means, even though I'm testing at 1440p, it basically means that we're not GPU bottlenecked in any scenario. There's one where we came close, but not quite. And then also I've got 30 gigs of RAM. In this video, all that RAM has been dropped down to 2600, just to, or 26666, 2600. But it's been dropped down just to make sure there's compatibility across the whole load of chips. Because if you remember back in the day, when the first gen of Ryzen came out, there was a whole heap of compatibility issues when you're running RAM too quickly. So I just thought, let's just run it really slowly. That does mean that the results potentially are lower than you'd normally get with these chips, the higher end chips, or the newer chips, I should say. But it just means that it's fair across the whole lot. So that's the system. It's worth saying that the reason I've chosen this, I could have potentially done the maybe the 800s or the 700s of each chip, but why I've chosen the 1600 or the 2600, because in the testing that I've done before, there's no real performance improvement from going higher than 6 cores, 12 threads. So all of these CPUs are 6 cores, 12 threads. The last thing to say is there is an asterisk by the 5600X results, because I didn't actually buy a 5600X because they cost lots and lots of money. And I have a 5900X. So what I've basically done is turned off half of the chip, and it then effectively becomes a 5600X. It will slightly clock slightly higher and the cache is slightly different, but effectively that chip now that I've tested this on effectively is a 5600X. So there is an asterisk around there. Apologies for not spending even more money than I already had. That's a load of talk. Let's get into the benchmarks. We're going to save the most interesting results for last, but here we are in a space which is not really CPU or GPU intensive. And you can see the scaling there. 1000 series up to 5000 series, and immediately you're going to get a sense of how much the improvement is and really how much better the 5000 series is than any of them. But all of those are playable. Again, in space, nothing's really going on, but yeah, that's pretty good. Let's move on. Next up, looking at the Arc Core Planet, and really it's the same sort of scenario as just in space. It's not particularly heavy on the CPU or the GPU, and the results are basically the same. Quantum Travel next, a relatively heavy GPU part of the game. That top result, 5600X, is nearly bottlenecked by the 3080 I've got, but it's not quite. Did some testing at 1080p just to make sure. But yeah, you can see the scale again going upwards with each generation, and they're all decent playable results. Horizon, our very own cloud city, very heavily normally on the GPU. In this case, I've turned the volumetric cloud settings down to medium so that the 3080 isn't affecting the results here. So all of these are still CPU bottlenecked. And you'll see the 1600 is low performance, less than half of the 5600X. And it's really then starting to hint at the issue here. In the cities, it is really, really struggling with all of the entities, everything that's going on. And actually, this scene here that's been taken, where I'm testing on the rooftop, it's not as intensive as down below in the rest of the city. So these results are actually quite good for Horizon. Wally's Bar on Microtech, and really when we look at the results here, we'll see that the 5600X and the 3600 are what I'd call Star Citizen playable. They're not good frames for any other game, but for Star Citizen, they're really quite good. In a city, I mean. But for the other two results, unplayable and not pleasant at all. You would not want to be in Wally's Bar with a 1600 or a 2600. It's really quite tricky to get around and just a bit of a stuttery mess. Louisville next, my favorite landing location to test. And I've done more testing here than I would care to tell you. And in these results, again, I've spent a lot of time doing each one, multiple runs. But we'll see in the results that the 5600X is significantly better than the rest of the results, percentage-wise especially. And again, it just really shows that the 5000 series is quite an impressive CPU, set of CPUs from AMD. They've done a really good job. The 3600, I would say, is definitely playable here. That's a good result again. But the bottom two, the 1600, I wouldn't recommend. If you've got one, I'd recommend upgrading. The 2600, I wouldn't go out and buy one, but if you've got one and you're struggling for money, it's definitely, you can get around, and it's not pleasant. And those 1% lows are really quite low, and there is some significant stuttering going on, but it's just about playable. So what to make of all this? Well, firstly, let's just put the obvious things out there. There's a clear progression between each generation of Ryzen. So there's a definite improvement, as we kind of expected. If you've been following this stuff at all over the last few years, you will know that AMD have basically stormed back into the CPU market with really good products. And the 5000 series especially is really impressive, really, really good. And actually, the 3000 series is very good as well. So I'd say if you can possibly, if you're looking for more star citizen performance and you're on the 1000 or 2000 series, the obvious thing is to try and upgrade as far as you can. It will depend what motherboard you've got. That would make a difference in terms of how new you can go, but a lot of people will be able to upgrade up to the 3000 and the 5000 series, and obviously 5000 is best, but actually I would say that 3000 series is very playable even in the cities. The 3000 series 3600 gives good performance, and so yeah, if you're on the 1000 or the 2000 series, that's very impressive. The other thing to talk about is that obviously when you start talking about upgrading computer parts, you're talking about timing, and there's never really a good time to upgrade. There are some bad times, but always when you're upgrading CPUs, especially at the moment, GPUs is just bad at the moment, full stop. But with a CPU, you're thinking, well, the next generation is coming, should I wait for that? And we've got to consider the fact that right now we're getting towards the tail end of 2021. AMD potentially going to release a newer version of their 5000 series with some faffing around with cache that might make a difference to performance in Star Citizen. And then you've got Intel are very likely to soon release their 12000 series, which hopefully it will be a return to some sort of form for Intel. They'll hopefully put out a decent product that is not crazily priced and not completely power hungry and full of heat. We'll see. But that will be interesting because they're using, it'll be on DDR5 as well. You'll be able to use that. And also we've got big performance cores and then also lower powered cores in those CPUs, so that would be interesting to see how that affects performance, if it makes any difference at all. And then obviously then looking into a bit further into the future, AMD will also then be releasing their next platform, which again will support DDR5, and then we'll also be looking at a new load of chips that won't be backwards compatible with the current Ryzen CPUs or motherboards won't be compatible. So again, that will be a big jump. And again, in theory, what we've proven almost in this video today is that the newer the CPU, the better your performance in Star Citizen, because single-threaded performance is absolutely key to Star Citizen. We know this, we've talked about this absolutely loads on this channel, but until Vulkan and Gen 12 renderer are fully implemented in Star Citizen, the faster and the newer the CPU, the better IPC, the better performance from that CPU, the better performance you get in Star Citizen. So what's likely to happen is these newer chips from AMD and Intel will likely perform slightly better. But basically, you have to make that decision. Are you willing to pull the trigger now, spend money, and then maybe a few months later you realize, oh, that's going to be better, or are you going to wait? You could wait forever and you could never buy anything, but it's up to you. So hopefully this has all been quite helpful, especially if you're on one of the older chips. And what I would say is like the video if you've liked it, subscribe, like I said, if you like this sort of content, looking at Star Citizen from a technical point of view, and you can even join the channel now. Whereas if you've got too much money, you don't know what to do with it, and you just want to give it to a random internet stranger, you can give me money every month. How crazy is that? But anyway, that's enough for now. I'll see you soon. Bye.